The Smith Cloud was first discovered in the early 1960s by Gail Smith. She was an American graduate student working at Leiden University in the Netherlands at the time when the Dutch astronomers had a radio telescope that they were using to just look around the sky and for the first time see where the hydrogen in the Milky Way, kind of the Milky Way's atmosphere, was located. She found this hydrogen cloud in a place where there was no real reason for there to be a hydrogen cloud. It would be kind of like seeing a cloud on Earth's atmosphere, but 100 miles up. And it's big on the sky. If you could see it with your eyes, it would be as big as the Orion constellation. It spans many, many, many degrees. And so she wrote a paper in 1963 about this cloud and speculated on its possible origins. She said it could be part of the Milky Way, just rotating around naturally with the rest of the Milky Way, that for some reason there's a structure that rises up very high in this place. She speculated that it could have been blasted out of the Milky Way by the explosion of a star. Or she also speculated that it could be falling into the Milky Way for the first time, maybe in the way that comets come into the solar system. Well, once the Green Bank Telescope was commissioned, I realized that that would be an ideal instrument for studying the Smith Cloud. We started a project to map out the hydrogen from the Smith Cloud, and very quickly on, we knew we were seeing something extraordinary, that this formless, kind of slightly elongated gas cloud revealed itself to have this incredible cometary structure that just indicated that it was plunging into the Milky Way, losing matter to the Milky Way. It was really adding mass, and now we know momentum, spin to the Milky Way disk. At the same time, we were able, through a couple of methods, to determine the distance to the cloud. And once you know the distance to an object, you can get an idea of how much mass it has. And it turned out that the Smith Cloud had more than enough material to make a million solar systems like the one that we're living in. How did such an object, so beautifully coherent, at an odd place, come to be falling into the Milky Way? I've sometimes described it as possible construction debris, material left over from the formation of the Milky Way. The contractor was a little late getting the cinder blocks there, and they're only now arriving. And the Smith Cloud is arriving a few billion years after the rest of the object got assembled. I mean, that's plausible, but it's just a story and doesn't explain what this thing is and what holds it together. Now, theories tell us that when galaxies like the Milky Way form, they form in these very large regions of dark matter. And dark matter is a mysterious stuff. We don't know what it is. It doesn't give off light. It doesn't absorb light. It doesn't interact with matter in any way that we know so far, except gravitationally. We feel it pulling, but otherwise we don't know anything about it. It's very uncertain. But theories tell us that there should be these clumps of dark matter 100 million times the mass of the Sun, floating around the Milky Way. And these things could be accreted onto the Milky Way, and they could have hydrogen, normal matter, in them. So what we could be seeing is just the tip of the iceberg, that the Smith Cloud is tracing a much larger dark structure that's plunging into the Milky Way.